Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the open collector TTL gates and the tri-state gates. So in the past couple of videos, we have seen the internal circuit of the TTL inverter, NAND gate as well as the NOR gate. Now in all these circuits, if you have observed the last stage, then that was the totem pole stage. So the advantage of this totem pole stage is that it offers the fast switching speed. Because in this totem pole stage, this upper transistor provides the active pull-up whenever it is in the on condition. And during the on condition, it offers the very low resistance. And because of that, it is able to drive the other TTL stages faster, and hence, it offers the fast switching speed. And the same is the case for the lower transistor. That means in the on condition, it provides the active pull-down, and it offers the lower resistance. And because of that, it offers the faster switching speed. So that is the advantage of the totem pole stage as the output stage in the TTL gates. But the issue with the totem pole stage is that in the high condition, the output voltage does not go beyond the 3.6 volt. And the second issue is that the output of the totem pole stages cannot be connected together. And in a way, it is not possible to perform the wired AND operation. So what is wired AND operation? I have already covered it in the separate video. So for more information, you can check this video. But here, first let us understand why the totem pole outputs cannot be connected together. So here, let's say we have a two TTL logic gates with the totem pole outputs and their outputs are connected together. Now when we connect the outputs of the totem pole stages together, then the main issue arises when both outputs are at the different logic level. So here, let's say the one output is at the logic low while the other output is at the logic high. So in this TTL gate, since the output is the logic low, so this Q4 transistor will be in the on condition. While if we see the Q3 transistor, then that will remain in the off condition. While for the second TTL gate, since the output is high, so this Q4 will remain in the off condition, while the Q3 will remain in the on condition. And when we connect these outputs together, then what will happen? This Q3 transistor will try to pull up the output voltage of this node, while this Q4 transistor will try to bring down the output voltage to the logic low. And since both are the active elements, so both transistors will fight to set the output voltage to either logic low or the logic high. And here, since the Q4 is offering the lower resistance path, so effectively, we will have the short circuit. And because of that, there is a chance of high flow of current between this Q3 and the Q4 transistor. And because of that, both the logic gates can get damaged. So to avoid that, these totem pole outputs are not connected together. And because of that, there is no way we can achieve the wired AND logic in these TTL gates with the totem pole outputs. But in these open collector TTL gates, it is possible to perform the wired AND logic. So as its name suggests, here the collector of this transistor Q4 is kept in the open condition. So if you see the earlier case of the totem pole output, then above this collector terminal, there was a diode and the transistor. But here in this open collector case, this collector terminal is kept open. And here, the output is taken through this collector terminal. So typically, in this open collector gates, the external pull-up resistor is connected at the collector terminal. So here, when this Q4 is in the on condition, then it operates in the saturation and this VCE is close to 0.2 volt. So because of that, the output of this gate will be logic low. And similarly, when this Q4 is in the off condition, then the voltage at the output is close to VCC. Because here, this output node is connected to the VCC via this pull-up resistor. And in this way, the output will be logic high. Moreover, in this logic high condition, the output will also be close to VCC. So here, the need of the pull-up resistor is that when the Q4 is in the off condition, then the voltage at the collector of this transistor will not be sufficient to considered as the logic high. So that is why we need the external pull-up resistor. And with this external pull-up resistor, it is possible to perform the wired AND logic. That means when we connect the outputs of this open collector gates together, then the overall output is the logic AND operation of the all the outputs. That means here, if any one of the output is low, then overall output will be logic low. And the overall output will be logic high when all the outputs are high. So first, let us see why is it possible to connect the outputs of the open collector gates together, and then we will see that how it performs the wired AND operation. So here we have a two TTL inverters with the open collector outputs. And here the output of the one TTL gate is low while the output of the other one is the high. And let's say their outputs are connected together. So here for the first logic gate, since the output is low, so this Q4 transistor will operate in the on condition. And similarly, for the second TTL gate, since the output is high, it means that its Q4 transistor will be in the off condition. So here, this Q4 transistor will try to pull down the output voltage at this node to the logic low. So here if you see, then on the other side, we have only passive element. So unlike the totem pole stage, we do not have any active component which can fight to pull the output voltage of this node to the logic high. And therefore, the output voltage at this node will get pulled down to logic 0. And effectively, now the output of this connected logic gates will be equal to logic low. That means in case of the open collector gates, since we have the passive pull-up network, so it is possible to connect the outputs together. And those output connections will effectively behave as the wired AND logic. Because here, if any one of the output is low, then the overall output of that node will be low. And it will become high when all the outputs are logic high. So that is how, when the open collector outputs of these TTL gates are connected together, then that performs the wired AND logic. So again, for more in-depth explanation, you can check this video. So that is the advantage of the open collector gates. But the issue with this open collector gate is that because of this external pull-up resistor, or basically due to this passive pull-up, the switching speed will be lesser compared to the totem pole stage. And hence, the propagation delay of these logic gates will be more. So one can argue that, what if we reduce the value of this pull-up resistor and make it comparable to the resistance value which is equivalent to the resistance offered by the active pull-up. So let's see what happens. So here if you observe, when the overall output is equal to logic low, then for this logic gate, the current will flow through this path. Moreover, the current through this pull-up resistor will also flow through this Q4 transistor. So here, if the value of the pull-up resistor is very much low, then the total current that is flowing through this Q4 transistor might become more than the IL max limit of this TTL gate. And because of that, it can damage the transistors. Moreover, the same thing can also happen when we connect the output of this open collector gate to the input of the TTL gates. So for example, if the output of this open collector gate is low, at that time, the current will flow through this Q4 transistor via this pull-up resistor. And moreover, this IIL current of this connected gate will also flow through this transistor. So if the value of this pull-up resistor is too low, then again, the total current that is flowing through this Q4 transistor will become more than the IIL max limit. So again, if you want to calculate what should be the minimum and the maximum value of the pull-up resistor, then I have already explained that in one of the earlier videos of the pull-up resistor. So for more information, you can check that video. But in short, that is why it is not possible to reduce the value of the pull-up resistor beyond the certain value. And that is why the propagation delay of this open collector gates will be more than the totem pole stage. Alright, so far we have seen the TTL gates with the totem pole output and the open collector output. So now, let us talk about the tri-state TTL gates. So if you see any standard logic gates, then it has only two states. That is logic high and the logic low. But these tri-state TTL gates have the three outputs. That is logic low, logic high and the high impedance state. So for that, these tri-state gates have the one more input. That is the control input. So let's say this data input is equal to X, while this control input is equal to enable input. So whenever this enable input is low, at that time, the output is in the high impedance mode. That means here, the output and input are not connected with each other. And in this condition, we can say that the output of this tri-state gate is in the high impedance mode. And now whenever this enable input is made to logic 1, then this gate will behave as the normal gate. And in that condition, depending on the input, we will get the output. So in case of this tri-state inverter, when the enable input is high, then it will behave as the normal inverter. So here in this inverter, when the input is low, then the output will be logic high. And similarly, when the input is high, then at the output we will get the logic low. So now, let us see the circuit of the tri-state TTL inverter and let us understand the working of this circuit. So if you see the circuit of this tri-state TTL inverter, then it is similar to the normal TTL inverter except the couple of changes. So here, since we have the two inputs, that is the data input and the enable input, so the current driving stage of this TTL inverter is now a multi-emitter transistor. And the second change is that, now at the base of the Q3, we have a one more diode. So here, the cathode of this diode is connected to the enable input, while the anode is connected to the base of the Q3. So now, let us see how this circuit works. So we know that, for the multi-emitter transistor, when any one of the input is low, then the base emitter junction will get forward biased. And because of that, this Q2 and Q4 transistor will remain in the off condition. So here, when this enable input is low, then the same thing happens. That means here, the base emitter junction of the Q1 will get forward biased. And because of that, the voltage at the base of the Q1 will be around 0.9 volt. And because of that, the voltage at the collector will be roughly equal to 0.3 volt. So because of this voltage, both Q2 and Q4 will remain in the off condition. And now, the voltage at the base of the Q3 or at the anode of this diode will be close to VCC. But here, since the enable input is low, so this diode will get forward biased. And hence, now the voltage at the base of the Q3 will be roughly equal to 0.7 volt. And this voltage will not be sufficient to turn this transistor Q3 in the on condition. Because here, for that, we at least require the 1.4 volt at the base of this transistor Q3. And in this condition, this Q3 will also remain in the off condition. So we can say that when the enable input is low, at that time, both Q3 and Q4 are in the off condition. And therefore, the output of this TTL gate is in the high impedance mode. Now whenever this enable input is high, at that time, the output of the logic gate depends on this A input. So whenever this enable input is logic high, then first, this diode will get reverse biased. Because now, the voltage at the cathode of this diode is close to 5 volt. And therefore, it will remain in the off condition. And therefore, now this circuit will work as the normal inverter. That means now, when this A input is low, then the output will be equal to logic high and it is close to 3.6 volt. And similarly, when the A input is high, at that time, the output will be equal to logic low. And in that condition, that is close to 0.2 volt. And in this way, this circuit works as the tri-state inverter. So I hope in this video, you understood the working of this open collector TTL gates and the tri-state gates. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.